In this video, we will try to understand typical example on shear force and bending moment diagram of cantilever beam. So we have to draw the shear force and bending moment diagram for a cantilever beam as shown in the figure. Total span length is 6 meter. Now here we are having the point load which is acting at the end, that is point D. Then from B to C the UDL is acting of 5 kN per meter. Then from A to B the UDL is acting, but it is from the opposite direction. And for this particular arrangement we have to draw the shear force and bending moment diagram. So let us start with the shear force diagram first. So as we can see over here, the conventions that we are always assuming for drawing the shear force diagram is that upward forces, they are considered as negative, whereas downward forces, they are considered as positive. Now shear force at point D is 20 kN, which is acting in the downward direction, so it is positive. Shear force at point C, as there is no load that is acting between D and C, the same shear force will exist at point C also, that is 20 kN. Between C and B, there is a downward acting uniformly distributed load or UDL of 5 kN per meter. As we have seen earlier, the meaning of 5 kN per meter is that for 1 meter length, the load that is acting is 5 kN. Then for 2 meter length, the load that is acting will be 5 into 2. And again, it is acting in the downward direction, so we have used the plus sign over here. So it is 20 plus 5 into 2, that is total will be 30 kN. Shear force at A will be equal to this 20, then this 5 into 2, and this particular UDL is acting in the upward direction, so we have used the negative sign over here. So it is again 5 into 2, but as it is acting in the upward direction, we have used the negative sign. Total load shear force at point A will be 20 kN, and therefore we can say that reaction at A is also 20 kN. Now let us draw the shear force diagram for this particular arrangement. So this is the baseline. Shear force at D is 20 kN. At C it is also 20 kN. At point B it is 30 kN. Again at point A it is 20 kN. So that will complete our shear force diagram. Now let us try to understand how to draw the bending moment diagram for this. Again, the conventions which we have used over here for bending moment calculations are clockwise negative and anticlockwise positive. At point D, the bending moment will be zero because there is no force that is acting on the right hand side of D. At point C, we have to consider all the forces which are acting on the right hand side of C. So this 20 into 2, that will produce the clockwise moment. So it is minus 20 into 2, that is minus 40 kN meter. Now for calculation of the bending moment, we will always convert the uniformly distributed load into point load. So once again, try to understand, at point D, the bending moment is zero because there is no force that is acting on the right hand side of D. At point C, this 20 kN force will produce the clockwise moment as shown by this particular arrow. So it is 20 into perpendicular distance is 2 meter from D to C. So 20 into 2, that is 40. But as it is clockwise and we have considered this convention as negative, it is minus 40 kN meter. Now shear force at B, again this 20 will produce the clockwise moment as indicated again by this same arrow, but the distance from D to C is 2 plus 2, that is 4, so 20 into 4, and again it is a clockwise, so it is negative. Then UDL is 5 into 2 and allow it to act at the center of 2 meter length, so that is 1 meter length, and again this will also produce the clockwise moment. So again 5 into 2, that is 10 kN, and perpendicular distance from this to this is 1 meter. So it is 5 into 2 into 1. So total will be minus 90 kN meter. Now finally we have to find out what will be the bending moment at point A. So this 20 will produce same again clockwise moment about point A, but the perpendicular distance now in this case will be 2 plus 2 plus 2 from point D up to A. The perpendicular distance is this 2 plus 2 plus 2, that is 6. So it is minus 20 into 6 because it is clockwise. Then this UDL, which we have converted into point load, is 5 into 2, but the perpendicular distance from this point of application up to A will be this 1 plus 2, that is 3. So it is 5 into 2 into 3. Now this particular another UDL, which we have converted into point load, that is 5 into 2, will produce the anti-clockwise moment, and that is positive. So 5 into 2, and what will be the perpendicular distance? It is 1. So we can see over here the perpendicular distance from this point of application up to point A where we are taking the moment is 1 meter, and as it is anti-clockwise it is positive, so it is 5 into 2 into 1. The total will be minus 140 kilonewton meter. So using these values we can draw easily the bending moment diagram. So this is our baseline. All the moments, they are negative, so it will be below the baseline. So this is first one, and then as this is the UDL, there will be a parabolic curve over here, and the various values also we have written. So in this way we can draw the shear force and bending moment diagram in case of some typical cases. Thank you very much for watching. Do subscribe to our channel. Thank you very much.